Hello, second year students. We are starting with a new practical, and the heading of the practical is isolation and identification of nitrogen fixing bacteria from soil sample. So, first of all, we will try to understand what is the aim. Isolation and identification. This is the heading of our practical. Now, how we are going to start the practical? First of all, we require the sample, and for that we should understand that how to prepare the sample and from where to get the sample. What are the different habitats of the nitrogen fixing bacteria? Okay. So first of all, we will go for habitat discussion, and then we will switch over to the procedure in which we will take different media. And we will also see that the reasons why we are taking these different media. And then after we will see the protocol of the doing practical. And then lastly we will see the result. And then after how to do the different steps in the result, what is to be done. Okay, how many are the findings we have to find out and how to write the conclusion. So everything we will try to cover in this discussion. So first of all, we will try to understand that what are nitrogen fixing bacteria. They are called nitrogen fixing. So the meaning of fixation here, fixing means nitrogen will now not allow to be move anywhere. Okay, so that is called immobilization of nitrogen gas. So how it will be possible? It is possible with the help of certain microorganisms, especially bacteria and algae. They carry out nitrogen fixation in the soil. They are found in the soil, and there are so many different varieties of bacteria, so many different varieties of algae. They carry out nitrogen fixation efficiently because they have a specific enzyme which is present in their cells, and that is nitrogenase. The name of the enzyme is nitrogenase. Okay, and with the help of these enzymes, the nitrogen fixation will be carried out by the organisms. So this is very first thing. Now we will see that why they are found in the soil. They are usually found in the soil because you know that soil is the best medium for growth of any microorganisms. Okay, and in the soil there are plants. There are so many different varieties of vegetation which is coming under the heading agriculture. Okay, so these all will be benefited because of the fixation of nitrogen. How they will be benefited? They will be benefited by the particular production. Okay, the nitrogen fixation will result in the production of nitrogenous compounds. Nitrogenous compounds will be produced from this nitrogen fixation, okay, with the help of particular enzyme. Now this enzyme is extremely sensitive to the amount of oxygen, so most of the time they have a specific mechanism by which they can save the enzyme content from the damages caused by the oxygen presence. Now these nitrogen will be fixed in the form of nitrogenous compounds. These nitrogenous compounds are nicely dissolved inside the water, and now this water can be taken up by the plants, and thereby the plants will get the nitrogen source. Nitrogen source will be obtained by the plants from the water in which nitrogenous compounds get dissolved nicely. Okay, there are various nitrogenous compounds which are produced by the fixation of the nitrogen by microorganisms. So now we can understand that how microorganisms are important for nitrogen fixation, how they are important for the growth of the plants. Okay, especially we talk about the nitrogen content of any plant. Okay, now these organisms are related with particular plants, and they are having different names. They are legume plants, they are green plants, and they are different grasses. Okay, so these are major three area of nitrogen fixing bacteria where they work symbiotically. They fix nitrogen from the atmosphere. Okay, so this is something which is very important to know, that how bacteria are useful to the plants. Okay, now directly what will happen, these all plants will give the shelter to the bacteria, and the bacteria will in turn give the nitrogenous compounds to these plants. Okay, so nitrogenous compounds will be taken up by their roots, this plant root, and then they will be very much rich in the nitrogen content, their fruits and their whatever the crop they will find out of these plants will be extremely rich in the nitrogen content. Okay, so this is the way how we can have the use of nitrogen fixers for enriching our agriculture. Okay, so that is about the nitrogen fixer. Now we will see about free living nitrogen fixers. Free living nitrogen fixers are also there. They are found directly in the soil. They do not require any type of shelter, but they independently can carry out nitrogen fixation by growing in the soil. Okay, so there are so many different genera of independent nitrogen fixers. They are called free living nitrogen fixers, or they are called by another name, non symbiotic nitrogen fixers. Okay, so they are also have so many different genera, like Azotobacter, Azomonas, Dowsia and Mengerinthia. These are traditional free living nitrogen fixers. Some other are also there, that also we will see further. Okay, but just now we will have understood that all free living nitrogen fixers are there, and they will carry out the nitrogen fixation by remaining inside the soil, growing inside the soil. Okay, so that is all.